Imagine you're on a fantastic safari in a spectacular crater, and you decide to stop and rest for a while to eat a beautiful pre-prepared picnic lunch. You might think to yourself, this is wild Africa. Any number of Mother Nature's curious creatures could stop by my picnic at any time. But picnic lunches happen every day in Ngorongoro Crater. There aren't rogue lion attacks. In fact, the big cats almost always steer clear of people. They don't really care about our picnics. Hippos are Africa's most dangerous mammal, but they only really come out at night. During the day, they're pretty lazy. Picnics don't interest elephants much. The crater doesn't have any crocodiles, so no worries there. Rhinos are so rare that they'd be a blessing to see anywhere. I would have been thrilled to have one at my picnic. Lone male buffalo are the ones to keep your eyes on, and your guide will definitely be on the lookout for them. They can get pretty cranky. But the one animal you would never guess might help themselves to your lunch is a raptor flying out of the sky. No, not that kind of raptor. This is Ngorongoro, not Jurassic Park. The class of birds known as raptors. They can see that you're eating fried chicken, and sometimes they want some. This is a black kite. She's a member of the largest group of raptors on the planet, and she's hungry. Black kites are opportunistic hunters, meaning when they see an opportunity for food, dead or alive, they'll go for it. Even if that food is in your hand. The moment I held up a chicken bone, this lovely bird swooped out of a nearby tree and headed straight for our table. Our guide reacted with cat-like reflexes, waving a stick to shoo her away. And after the rest of us finished wetting ourselves from the shock of it all, we noticed the black kite had returned to the exact same branch she started from and was still staring at my chicken.
It's a black kite that has since twice dive-bombed Brian, who is a vegetarian, attempting to steal chicken.
She spent the entire lunch with us, waiting for someone to make one false move with a leftover piece of meat. She even gave flying down at us a couple more goes before we all parted ways. We were never in any real danger. Her eyesight and pinpoint accuracy are far superior to mine, and if our guide hadn't noticed her, she'd probably have picked the chicken cleanly out of my hand. In the end, it's this great story I get to tell about having lunch in Ngorongoro Crater with a lovely black kite. And the voyeuristic vervet monkeys thought the whole thing was totally hilarious.
This is the best safari lunch we have ever had.
You gotta erase some of this shit.